Walker, the drive, gets inside, leans in, knocked away, it's stolen by Holiday. Phoenix has to foul, and a pinnacle ball throws it down. And a foul. Giannis on the alley-oop. What a turnaround. A chance to take the lead and the turnover.
What a play by Jrue Holiday.
Malone is doubled. They swat at it and steal it. Here comes Chicago. 17 seconds. 17 seconds from game 7 or from championship number 6. Jordan. Open. Chicago with the lead. 5.2 seconds left. Michael Jordan running on fumes with 45 points.
He's beat you so many times. You watch Jordan play, Doug, and you know that at the end of the game, he's a killer.
5 seconds remaining in regulation. The inbound. Six-tenths of a second remaining. It's a four-point lead.
Worthy will inbound to Magic Johnson. Worst comes to worst, the Celtics will have to foul. And there's a steal by Henderson, who lays it up and in. Bedlam in Boston, but it's not over yet.
The leprechaun at work here at Boston Garden. A steal right when you need it. Fabled things have happened, and this will be one of them if the Celts win this game. A steal by Gerald Henderson.
For a minute there, I could hear Johnny Bruce going, Henderson steals the ball.
The ball is out to Sam Jones, veteran Boston guard. He'll bring in to Bob Cousy, number 14, if he can. West is between them on defense. Watch West. He taps it away, tries to beat the clock, beats Cousy, beats the clock. The Lakers win it.
With only seconds remaining, Andy Phillip pushed the ball up court. But as he tried to dish it off, George King stepped in front of the pass, and the Syracuse Nationals held on to win 92-91 for their first NBA championship.